I spend far more time arguing on the internet than can possibly be healthy.
We get a lot of really angry, really uninformed comments on SciQ. Things like,
your Uber video is just taxi company propaganda.
Women don't belong in the military.
Climate change? It's not caused by humans. It's because of the sun. Duh.
I don't have to vaccinate my kids if I don't want to.
Now, I thought that we had to respect these views because, hey, that's your opinion. That's your belief. And because they're opinions or beliefs, they can't be challenged. That somehow opinions can't be incorrect because they're personal.
But what we're starting to realize is that there's a big difference between opinions and preferences. What a lot of people claim are opinions are actually just an excuse for being dead wrong. Adding the words, this is my opinion, doesn't give you license to say stuff that's just frankly incorrect.
Opinions and beliefs have become a shield to protect the racist, the sexist, and the misinformed from having to pay respect to facts. So I'm here today to say that that's not your opinion. You're just wrong. So before you say that you're above the laws of argument because that's your opinion, ask yourself, is this actually an opinion? And if so, how informed of an opinion is it?
Opinions are supposed to be preferences. I think peanut butter should be added to everything. I don't like ball sports. And I think Donald Trump is way too orange. These are my opinions. They may be unique to me alone, or they may be massively shared across the general population, but they all have one thing in common. They can't be verified outside of the fact that I believe them. And there's nothing wrong with having an opinion on those things. You can have all the opinions you like.
The problem comes from people whose opinions are actually misconceptions. If you think that vaccines cause autism, you're expressing something that is factually wrong. And the fact that you might still believe that vaccines cause autism does not move your misconception into the realms of valid opinion.
Now, scientists don't like saying this because in science, there is no facts. There's just theories with lots of evidence that maybe one day will be proven wrong. Like the idea that the Earth is flat. That was an obvious fact to anyone with eyes in the 1500s, yet it got proven wrong. So scientists can sometimes be reluctant to definitively say whether someone is wrong.
Sometimes there's genuinely areas of science and technology that are up for opinion. So I think whether or not there's a God is one of those things because there's not enough facts on either side to make a really clear, indisputable case either way. Also things like, why is there a gender pay gap? Or what can we do about climate change? There's no way to come up with a definitive answer on those questions. We can only guess at the answers and hopefully do it in an educated manner.
But a lot of the time, people have incorrect views on something because they're not looking at all of the facts.
So take gun control, for example. The overwhelming evidence suggests that people who own guns are considerably less safe than people who do not own guns. People who have guns in their house are way more likely to shoot themselves or others. And so owning a gun doesn't make people safer. Yet many people still believe that it does. And sure, these people will do a hat tip to the facts by citing a study or two that supports their case. But by choosing to look at just one or two studies that they agree with, they've reached a narrow opinion based on a narrow set of information. So you're choosing to be ignorant of all the information that's out there.
There's a big difference between a belief and something that you just didn't know.
Now, it would be totally okay to have an incorrect opinion if people were willing to accept new information. So, for example, if you'd been exposed to the book More Guns, Less Crime, you might genuinely believe that guns make people safer. But then you watched this SciQ episode, learned that most of the information in that book is just plain made up, and then you changed your opinion based on the new information. That's how it's supposed to work in science. We get new data, and so we update our theories. But let's be real, most people would rather die than give up their incorrect opinions. And in fact, tragically, a lot of people do. And it really scares me that some people will see education or information that challenges their ideas as a personal attack on their beliefs. Like, that's why when I go through the evidence of climate change or gun control or the pay gap or vaccines, many people will leave comments like, I've personally reached through the YouTube screen and slapped them in the face. The only way to solve this problem of incorrect opinions is to remember that your opinions are not you. If you want to always be right, you need to be willing to change your mind. Many, many, many of your opinions will turn out to be uninformed or just plain wrong. The fact that you believe them doesn't make them any more valid or worthwhile, and nobody owes your viewpoint any respect simply because it's yours. You can be wrong, or you can be ignorant, it'll happen. Reality doesn't care about your feelings. And so after thinking about this stuff for a really long time, I've decided SciQ is going to take a new approach. I wanted this show to be impartial and fact-based, and for a long time I thought that that meant considering every opinion as if it was sacred, even if it was just an incorrect idea dressed up as an opinion. But no longer. SciQ will no longer be tolerant of ignorant people and will instead only look at the facts. One part of this is that we need to keep the most open mind possible, and I'm ready to be wrong. And I'm really grateful for all of you guys for whenever we make a mistake, you're there with the evidence that we were missing, so thank you. But we are no longer going to be respectful of misinformation. Oh, you think that women can't pass the military entrance test? You think climate change is a conspiracy? You think vaccines are wrong and GMOs are more harmful than helpful? You think Uber really is the highest paying transport job, or that black people are genetically more crime prone than white people, or that ISIS is the most dangerous thing in America? You think Planned Parenthood commit more abortions than any other kind of medical service, or you think that soy milk makes your boobs bigger? No, that's not your opinion. You're just wrong. If you're interested in the truth, based on the strongest evidence, then SciQ is the place for you. If not, we'll no longer be respecting your opinions. Sorry, not sorry.
Hi everyone, I'm Jayde Lovell, resident science nerd on the Young Turks Network. You're watching SciQ, and we know you don't want to miss an episode, so please click the subscribe button down below.